Okay, so today we are going to divide with decimals. Take a look at the terminology. We've got to know the inside the house is the dividend. The divisor is your number that you're dividing by, and your answer is the quotient. All right, so this first number is your dividend, and it always goes inside the house. So we'll place it right here. 4 is the divisor, and it goes right here. In this first example, I want to make sure that you understand, in the divisor, we always have to have a whole number. And this is a whole number, so we're good. So the decimal point in this situation can just come straight up, and we're finished placing it. And then divide like usual. 4 goes into 4 one time. 1 times 4 is 4. Subtract. Bring down. 4 goes into 7 one time. 1 times 4 is 4. Subtract. Bring down your next number. And 4 goes into 32 8 times. 8 times 4 is 32. So there you have it. So let's look at another example.
Okay.
So as you can see, this next example, the numbers, the digits are a little larger, right? So we'll write 523 and 6 tenths inside the house. This is our dividend. 34 is our divisor. It's a whole number. So our decimal placement will just move straight up. Now, this is our first experience with two-digit divisors. 34 will not go into 5, but it will go into 52 one time. 1 times 34 is 34. Subtract. And bring down the next number. Now, this situation, you probably don't know what 34 times what something will to go into 183, right? So you're thinking, I need to probably make an estimate. This could be 30, and the 183 is about 180. So 30 goes into 180 about 6 times. But let's see, it might go over. Let's check. 34 times 6 is 24, 18, 19, 20. Okay, so that goes over. We can't go over, so let's go back one. 5 times 4 is 20. 5 times 3 is 15, 16, 17. Subtract. Bring down your next digit. All right, so again, and make sure that you erase when you're multiplying, so you won't add that again, because that would make a mess. All right, so 34 goes into 136. And what we need to do is make another estimate. How many times will 30 go into about 140? Okay, so that's going to be about 4. Let's see if that works. 4 times 4 is 16. 4 times 3 is 12 plus 1 is 13. So that worked out perfectly. Now, it's really not that hard, but when you have these larger digit or the divisors with two digits, you may have to come over to the side and do some work to see how many times it will fit in to another number. All right. Now, there's a different situation coming soon. So let's try another one. All right, so let's take a look at this example. Let's write it in the house, 475 divided by 2.5. Now, you may have heard me mention earlier, this divisor needs to be a whole number. Okay, and so we've got to think about, well, how can we make it a whole number? So let's write this as a fraction, 475 over 2.5, because this means the same thing as division. If we want to make a whole number out of 25 with the powers of 10, remember if we just say times 10, that will move our decimal place one time over. And we'll get the whole number 25, and that's what we need. So let's do the same thing to the top number, 475 times 10, just add a zero. So when we do that here, You'll move the decimal one place to make the whole number 25. Do the same in the dividend and add a zero. Now we can extend this, and here is our decimal point right here. Okay? All right, now we can just divide like usual. 25 goes into 47 one time. 1 times 25 is 25, and subtract. Bring down the 5. 25 goes into 225 9 times. 9 times 5 is 45. 9 times 2 is 18, plus 4 is 22. And subtract. Can 25 go into 0? No. So put a 0 here. 0 times 25 is 0. And we're finished. So our quotient is 190. All right? Now, I have one more example I want to show you. All right, so for the last example, this one is going to be work very similar to the last one, but there's a slightly little different situation at the end. All right, so let's write 20 inside the house. That's your dividend. 1.6 as the divisor. Remember, we want this to be a whole number. So we want this to become a 16. And here's our decimal. So let's do the same in the dividend and move the decimal over one place, adding a zero to fill in the empty spot. Bring your decimal straight up. Now just divide. 16 goes into 20 one time. Subtract and get 4. Bring down your next number. 16 goes into 40 2 times. 2 times 16 is 32. Subtract and get 8. Now in the past, we wrote this as our remainder 8. In the past, we also interpreted this remainder as a fraction. And we said 8 over 16, which we could simplify to 1/2. But if we want to do it the new way, we would continue and do it with an additional zero. So let's add an additional zero here because we want to fill this in and continue the decimal. So bring down the zero, and this becomes 80 now. 16 will go into 80 5 times. 5 times 6 is 30. 5 times 1 and 3 more is 8. Now, we're finished. 20 divided by 1.6 is 12 and 5 tenths. All right, so just a quick recap. Remember, the divisor must be a whole number. If it's not, move over and do the same thing to the dividend that you do to the divisor. Place your decimal straight up once you do that, and you'll have it. All right.